December 4th, 2004, I was flipping through the New York Times and I saw Ron's obituary. And there was a picture of Ron in court that day on April the 15th, 1999, when he was exonerated and set free. And I was struck by the question, how could a guy like this end up on death row and almost get executed for a murder he didn't commit? And so I called New York to my editor and I said, well, read the obituaries and call me back. I found my next book. You know, if I wrote The Innocent Man as a novel, folks probably wouldn't believe it. And it was my only foray into nonfiction. Every trip to Ada introduced me to more and more characters. The documents, the paperwork itself was overwhelming. I had tons of sworn testimony. So it made my job easier in that I didn't have to go chase witnesses around. You know, I knew what every witness would say in the trial. They've already said it once or twice, under oath.